Hey guys, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Today I'm going to talk about why hormone blood tests are, for the most part, a big waste of time and money, except if you do it correctly, which is what I'm going to discuss today. And this is going to be a really important video and topic, so much so that it's going to be a three-part series. Now, I've put in a lot of time and effort for you into this because it's a really important topic which affects every aspect of your health, which is hormones. So please watch each of the three series all the way through, especially this first one, which sets the background for the next two. And again, today's topic is so important because it's all about something I really love, and that's hormones. And as I stated many times in the past, genetics aside, the reason you look and feel the way you do is because of your hormones. And keep something in mind, your lifestyle, you know, the foods you eat or don't eat, the exercise, your stress management, and the supplements you take, the herbs and vitamins and so forth, which I consider as epigenetics, again, also affect your hormones. Again, it's a genetic thing. Now, just think about how much people change the minute they go through puberty. You know, as much as your body changes, and of course, even your mind, your attitude and personality and emotions and so forth. Or the differences in men and women. It's very much hormone related. For example, you put a woman on testosterone or even steroids, and how she looks and acts, her body, her mindset, and so forth, all changes, and she becomes more manly. Same with the guys, all right? You put them on estrogen or female hormones and progesterone and so forth, they become more feminine. They start to get fatter, they become more moody, more emotional, their sex drive drops, they lose muscle, they grow man boobs and put more fat around their chest and so on and so forth. So if maybe, for example, you're at the gym all the time and yet you're having a hard time gaining muscle or losing fat, it's all so much hormone related. For example, let's just say you and your girlfriend can be doing the same exact workouts at the gym, eating the same foods, taking the same supplements, and I see this all the time, yet she will never, ever, ever perform like you. She'll never have as much muscle or be as lean or strong as you. All right. However, you put her on steroids and wow, then you've got yourself a challenge. So your goal should always be to improve, balance, and optimize your hormones and keep them youthful and young. And I mention all this because whenever I take on a new client, one of the first things I do is do a full hormone blood test on them. Of course, I do lots of other tests, genetic testing and gut bacteria, medical history, and so forth. But the hormones are the main priority. Unfortunately, most doctors who do blood tests will just do the basics. And again, as I stated earlier, it's a complete waste of time and money. Most doctors, even the endocrinologists, the hormone doctors, have no idea which hormones to test for. Or if they do, they just don't care to deal with it. By the way, in part two of this series, I will reveal the list of all the hormones to test for that you should be doing and why, so you'll know exactly what's going on in your body. And in part three, I'll show you where to go online so you can get these important blood tests without a doctor or a prescription. You'll just select what you want, pay for it, and go to your local lab, and you get the results in just a couple of days. It's easy breezy, and you're in charge of your health. And I'm doing all this because the typical doctor will, at best, do a quick, testosterone test and will say, you have low testosterone, or you're within the normal range, nothing to worry about. But this tells you nothing about why, or the improvements that can be made, or maybe why you just don't look and feel the way you do, even though the tests say your normal ranges. For example, if your testosterone is low, or not as high as it should be within that range, it could be for a variety of reasons. For example, your testosterone is lower because it's converting more to female hormones, such as various estrogens and estradiol, which means you're going to be fatter. You're going to have more fat around your chest. You're not going to be as driven in life. You're going to have lower sex drive. You're going to get moody or be more depressed. Or your testosterone is converting more to DHT, dihydrotestosterone, which is the primary hormone that causes balding and hair loss and excess body hair and prostate problems. Or your stress hormones, such as cortisols, are elevated, and that indirectly lowers your testosterone. Or maybe it's a combination of all three of these. Now, for me, I'll be honest, and I'm going to share a quick story with myself. I was 19. I did the full hormone test because I kept pushing about this topic, and the results showed that my testosterone was low but normal, but yet I had very high estrogen and high DHT levels, again, within the normal range. But I saw there was an imbalance, and then my stupid doctor wouldn't even listen to me, and that things were not obviously balanced or optimal. He kept saying, you're within the normal ranges, right? Which, by the way, is a really big range. And here's the problem. I was 19 years old, right? This was as good as it was ever going to get. And the older I get, the worse the hormones would be, obviously. And I told him that my hormones are not optimal. And yet, he just didn't care. Of course, the silver lining, the good news, is that that moment changed my life. And it's probably a huge, big reason why I became a hormone and anti-aging doctor and why I feel such a deep need to help others, so you don't go through all the pain and suffering that I did. Anyway, the point with all this is about having optimal ratios and balance. For example, if you had a new job or a new business, right, and you made $1 million a year, you'd be super happy, right? But not if later you found out that you had $2 million in expenses, right? You're losing money. Now, a good accountant would tell you this at the beginning, to save you time and money, all right? Similarly, a smart doctor or endocrinology hormone specialist would know about all this as well. By looking at a complete blood test, a smart doctor can pinpoint the imbalances and potential deficiencies. Then, making adjustments in your life, such as your diet and exercise, stress management supplements, to help make improvements in your hormones, and the end result is that you look and feel amazing. You look younger and you have better energy. And they would not look to quickly give you drugs. We should always first make all the improvements in your life doing natural methods. Drugs are your last option. In fact, this is why I created the natural solution Alpha Viral for us guys, because it helps balance out all these hormones. This is why it's got clinical proof and over 20 years of documented results. Now, it's one of my best sellers because it works. And this is why guys keep using it month after month, because they love how they look, feel, and perform. Now, you can get more details about Alpha Viral and how it works and all the improvements it'll make in for your different hormones. You can get the information below in the description area. Additionally, you can get access to part 2 of this video series, which I list the specific and exact hormones you want to test for and why.